Good morning, students. Welcome to the virtual classrooms. We are studying it as an alcohol phenols and ethers, the chapter number 11, in which we studied it as in preparation of alcohols and phenols. Today we will study the physical properties of the alcohols and phenols. Now when we are talking about the physical properties of the any given compound, in our first chapter we already studied for the organic compounds that we are going to discuss mainly related to the boiling points and solubilities, right? So here we will be discussing it about the boiling points of alcohols and phenols. So the first one that we are going to discuss, that is as the number of OH group increases, boiling point, melting point of alcohols and phenols increases. Now what is the reason behind it? When we are talking about more number of OH groups, that means we are saying it that there is a possibility of more number of H bonds. More number of H bonds means stronger forces of attraction. That means the boiling point, melting point will be increased. So here the reason that we will be writing it is number of OH group increases, the number of H bond increases, that is attraction increases, right? This is because of H bond. Similarly, if we compare it as boiling point of alcohol, phenol are higher than alkyl or aryl halides, that means we are want to write it as the boiling point of alcohol is higher than that of the alkyl halides, phenols are higher than that of the aryl halides. What is the reason behind it? When we are having it as an aryl halides, RX, it's a CX bond, right? Whereas in the alcohol, we are having it as an COH. Now in this case what happens? This one is going to become partially negative, partially positive. So this one is a polar bond. This one you are going to get it as partially positive, partially positive. Why? This is going to get it as partially negative. So both these bonds are going to become there are two polar bonds between COH group. At the same time, we also see that this is one of the point. The second point is electronegativity of oxygen is more than electronegativity of the oxygen is more than that of the halogen, right? Now see, two reasons are there. Polarity is more, electronegativity is also high, and as a result of both these cases, you can say that alcohols are having higher melting point, boiling point compared to that of alkyl halides, right? So that is your second, that give reason can be there for you. See, these are the reasons. These are specific reasons that you are indicating it. They can be the statements. This can be the statements as physical properties. At the same time, with give reason, they can ask you. So the reasons are this, right? Okay. Third one that we are having it is as the number of as the number of carbon atom increases. That means what will happen here? We will be taking it as an example of CH3OH, CH3CH2OH, CH3CH2CH2OH. As the number of carbon atoms are increasing, what is happening? The reason we will be having it, molecular weight increases, melting point, boiling point. So as the number of carbon atoms are going to increase in the compound, with increase in the molecular weight, their melting point, boiling point will also increase. Right? This is your third point. The next point. See, all these points are going to be a give reason for you. It's not necessary that write a short note on the physical properties of alcohols or physical properties of phenols will be asked. They can ask any one of it, give reason. Right? The fourth one we are having it. That is, boiling point decreases from primary to tertiary alcohols. When I'm moving it from primary to tertiary alcohols, boiling point decreases. That is, if this time I'm having it as in same number of carbon atoms, I'm having it as in same number of carbon atoms. Four, this one is your primary alcohol. This one is your secondary. And this one is your tertiary alcohol. We are having it as a primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol. It shows that boiling point decreases from primary to tertiary. What is the reason behind it? We can say that here the reason is branching increases intermolecular distance, decreases attraction, decreases, so boiling point also decreases. So here we know it that as we are moving it from primary to secondary to tertiary, we are getting it here no branch. Here we are having one branch. Here we are having two branches. So more the number of the branches, it's an easier to have a breaking of the molecules. So at a low temperature also, they can be broken up. As a result, branching increases, intermolecular distance decreases, attraction decreases. We can say that boiling point also decreases. Right? The fifth one, phenols. Yes? Higher boiling point, phenols are having this terminator. Phenols are having has higher boiling point than alcohols. Now, what is the reason behind it? We will take it as an example of phenol containing OH group. If I'm taking it as an alcohols, CH3CH2CH2CH2. I'm also having it as in 6 carbons in the given compound. But still, this is having higher boiling point compared to that of the alcohols. Reason for it, phenols has resonance. And because of this resonance, stability increases, and as a result boiling point also increases. Right? So that is because of phenols having a resonance have higher boiling point than that of the alcohols. The sixth one, the next one we are having it. O-nitrophenol has lower boiling point than P-nitrophenol. That is, now we are having both of as an aromatic nucleus. Both of them are having resonance, but still one is having an, now see, everything is identical. Both of them are having NO2 group, both of them are having OH, both of them are having benzene nucleus. So we can say that neither the molecular weight difference is there. We are not having even the number of H bond difference, no number of carbon difference, no change in the functional group. Everything is identical. Still their boiling points are different. Now what is the reason behind it? So in this case, the reason we are going to say it that when you are having it as an OH group attached with NO2, it's going to produce intramolecular H bond. While in case of P-nitrophenol, we are going to get it as see, there is a difference, intra, inter, and we know that intermolecular hydrogen bond are stronger compared to that of intramolecular hydrogen bond, and therefore because of intramolecular hydrogen bond, its boiling points are less, right? The next one, solubility of alcohols are higher than alkylates. Now here we are comparing it for solubility with alkylates. Now we know it that what we are going to get it, alcohols are going to be more soluble because they can produce H bond with water. As alcohols can produce H bond with water, they are more soluble than alkyl halides because of tendency of producing H bonds, they are more soluble. Right? Okay. Similarly, we want it now, comparing it with alcohols itself. Now, as the number of carbon atom increases, what will happen? The solubility decreases. Now we know it that molecular weight increases, the density of the compound will increase, and so the solubility decreases. So here we are going to indicate it as molecular weight increases, solubility decreases. So from this we can see that more as the carbon atom increases, the solubility decreases. But now the question arises that if we are having it as an more the number of carbon atoms, and if we say that the solubility decreases, glucose is having 6 carbons. Is it soluble or not? It's a soluble. But why? If I take it as an butanol, it's an insoluble, it's having 4 carbons. So here, what we are going to say it as, for one functional group, one OH group, presence of one OH group, solubility up to 3 carbon atoms. to 3 carbon atoms. The solubility, 1 OH group up to 3 carbon atoms. Now when we are talking about the glucose, it contains 5 OH groups and therefore it's a soluble in water, right? When we are taking it as in comparing it with the butanol, C4H9OH contains 1 OH group and so it is insoluble in water because its ratio is not maintained, 1:3. Right? Now this is not a particularly the key reason that they are asking us. As in multiple choice, as an objective question, they can be asking us in them the following compounds in the ascending descending order of their solubilities. Right? They may give us a compound. We are having it as an ethanol. We are having it as an ethylene glycol. Propane 1,2,3 triol. And glucose. We are having it as in 4 components. At that time, they may ask us which one is the maximum soluble in water. Now, here we want to see the two factors. First of all, number of OH groups, and the second factor, ratio. Ratio of OH with carbon atoms. Seeing the two factors, we will be able to answer the whole question. Now, if we find out first of all the ratio, what we will be finding it? 1 OH group, we are having it as in 2 carbon atoms. Here, for the this one was for the first one. For the second one, what we will be having it? We are having 2 OH, 2 carbons. Right? That means we can say that 1:2, 1 is the ratio. Here, 1:2 is the ratio. If we go it for the third one, we are going to get it as 3:3 OH and carbon. So again this is 1:1 ratio. And the fourth one, if we go for it, we are having it as an 5 OH group to 6 carbons. That means we are getting 1:1.2. Right? We got it as 1:1.2. So we are having it as a ratio of the carbon atoms. Now which one is having a maximum ratio? We can say that this is 1:2, this is 1:1.2. This is the smallest ratio, 1:1. So this should be highly soluble. Right? Now both of them are having 1:1. Then in those two, which one is more soluble? So in that two, can I say that this is having 2 OH, this is having 3 OH. So this is 3 OH maximum soluble. The 3 OH group is maximum soluble. Now in that, after that you will be getting it as in this one. So can I write it now the ratio as 3 is highly soluble than 2. 2 is more soluble. Now left out 1 and 4. 1 is having 1:2. 4 is having 1:1.2. So here the ratio is comparatively less as compared to that of the 2. So we will be having it as an fourth one, more soluble than the first one. So this is the order that we are going to get it. Or if I want to check the order, this is a particular method through which I can identify which one is going to be more soluble. So that ratio is going to be very important for us. Okay, so that were the physical properties of alcohols, phenols. Okay, next one, we are having it as an chemical properties of alcohols and phenols. So first of all, we will study only chemical properties of alcohols. Once we complete it, the alcohols, we will study about phenols. So one by one we will do it. Right? Okay. Now when we are talking about the chemical properties of the alcohols, again, these properties we are going to classify it into two types. The first one, when we are having it as an alcohol present in it, and I want to go it for its chemical property. So at that time, what will happen? I can dissociate only H plus, Ro minus, H plus. So that means during the reaction, we are simply replacing H. Can I say that this is electrophile? So we are going to get it as electrophilic substitution reaction. So we are having it as in the first property as electrophilic substitution. Similarly, when you are having it as an ROH, there is a possibility of a complete OH group is removed. That means you are getting it as an R plus OH minus. This is nucleophile. OH minus is going to act as a nucleophile. So that means our chemical property, we are going to classify it as nucleophilic substitution. That means when we are going to discuss about the chemical properties of the alcohols, we are going to get it as in two types of chemical properties of the alcohol: electrophilic substitution and nucleophilic substitution reaction. Two different properties. So one by one, again, in the alcohols itself, we'll study first of all which are the chemical properties of electrophilic substitution, and then we will study about the chemical properties of nucleophilic substitution. So first of all, electrophilic substitution reactions of alcohols. Now, in it, our first reaction is reaction of alcohols with metals. Reaction of alcohols with metals. That means I'm writing it first of all, generalized reaction. Alcohol, it's reacted with metal, sodium metal. Now we know that sodium is having it as an one valency. Sodium has only one electron in its outermost orbit. So it can substitute only 1H plus. So we are going to get it as RONA, and H plus is given out. This is known as sodium alkoxide. In common, this is written out as general reaction. If we take it as an CH3OH reacted with Na, it gets converted into CH3ONA and H plus. This is going to become as sodium. It's an methanol, so it produces methoxide, right? If it would be an ethanol, it would have produced ethoxide, propanol, propoxide, butanol, butoxide. So in common, alcohol produces alkoxide. So that is reaction with Na. That is a primary valency, single valency containing component. Now in place of that Na, you can also react it with Mg. But during that case, what will happen? Because Mg is a bivalent compound, its valency is 2. So it will react with 2 OH groups. So it will produce Ro twice Mg, and H2 gas is given out. It will produce Ro2Mg, right? Here if I want to make it as a neutral compound, we will write it as half H2. Right, so we got it as an H2 over here, two molecules. If we are having it as an CH3OH reacted with Mg, two moles will react CH3O twice Mg. It is also termed as metal alkoxide, right? Similarly, you can also react it with Al. It's a trivalent compound. So three molecules are going to react. It's going to produce RO thrice Al plus 3/2 H2. So this is going to be an important to indicate it while you are reacting with metals. Different metals. You can have it as a different number of molecules of alcohol reacted with it and produces respectively that many number of hydrogen atoms also. Right? Okay. The second property, that is a quite bigger one to consider the acidic character of the given compound. So we will do it in our next lecture. Today a smaller property is also there of it, the second property, that is esterification. The second one we are taking, it is a esterification reaction. Now what is esterification reaction? Your alcohol is fixed. You can react it with acid. In presence of H plus, it gets converted into RCOO R dash plus H2O. Right? It produces ester. During this reaction, it's going to lose OH. H OH. Right? It's a fixed acid is going to lose OH. Now why it is so? We can see that in place of an acid, if I reacted with acid halide RCOX, then also the ester formation takes place. It takes place as so here X is removed, H is removed. So that shows that alcohol always loses H and acid always loses OH. Right? Now in place of this, you can also go it for the reaction of ROH with R dash CO twice O. It is also going to produce R COR dash plus, you are going to get it as R dash COH. Ester plus acid. Right? So this particular reaction shows that this is a particular esterification, and all of them are always carried out in presence of acidic medium. So that is necessary to be shown. Right? So that is the esterification of alcohols or phenols with acids, acid chlorides or anhydrides. These are particularly known as alcohols with acid. The second one we can say it as acid halides, and the third reaction we term it as anhydrides. All of them are producing esters. Okay, we saw it as some of the chemical properties for electrophilic substitution. Still one of the chemical property of the alcohol which is representing the electrophilic substitution, that is the acidic nature. But we want to compare the acidic nature of the compounds in a different conditions. So we will discuss it in our next lecture. Thank you.